You've got to look at the clubs. A well-run league has well-run clubs. So if you think about, let's say, in the Premier League, you have Man United, Arsenal, Chelsea, Liverpool. These clubs are privately owned. These clubs are invested into by private individuals or sometimes corporations. They put money into the club. The club then invests that into facilities, operations, and stadia. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Now, if we're being honest, then, you know, for me, I've been in Kenya football for 12 years now. We haven't had clubs receive any investment, and therefore they haven't been able to invest in facilities, youth training facilities more specifically, and or any stadia. Now, a club is a business, and if a business is to have any sustainability and or longevity, then it must have assets. And these assets are, in football, youth training facilities and stadia. Now, in Kenya, we all know that our football clubs primarily are all registered as societies, and therefore they can't receive any investment. That's a big problem. So if we want a professional league, and you know, there's two sides of football. There's the national game and there's the professional game. The KPL and the clubs, that's the professional game. The national team is the national game. I'm speaking specifically about the professional game, and the clubs need investment. And to do that, they need to be incorporated as limited companies. And in Kenya, we already have the Companies Act around 15, which is a very good piece of legislation, which provides for good corporate governance. So as we're talking about now, corporate governance is transparency, accountability, and making sure that whenever you have an operation, it's being run in the best interests of not just the stakeholders, but also the community at large.